about the school was grand, amazing. And I thank the school authorities for giving me an opportunity to be here with you, this young crowd, on this wonderful day. I am absolutely elated. While I was here, I was reading, you know, some things about your school. The best thing which I could get from that pamphlet was the vision of the school. Creating potentialities into realities. And let me be very honest with you again. I see a lot of potential here in this ground today. The school has given you wonderful opportunities in all fields, be it sports or education. You must utilize these facilities to the benefit of yours to the most. Remember, these facilities are not available to most of the Indians which you have over here. Coming on to the parade, let me tell you the kind of drill movement I have seen over here today. I felt that is some Air Force contingent which is, you know, doing the drill movements. Your turnout was impeccable. Drill movements good, very good. And I can see the kind of efforts were put in to put up such a kind of show over here. I myself has done drill movements. It is not easy. It is quite excruciating, and the moment you finish, it gives you a lot of pains. I am very happy to see the smiling faces on the parade ground. While I was coming to your school and started my journey from Bangalore, I saw a butterfly there, and I remembered, you know, I have to talk about the butterfly today with the school students. Though in today's scenario, we're not finding much butterflies in the atmosphere because most of them are perishing. We must have read about the stages of a butterfly. We all have read in our, you know, 6th, 7th, 8th standard books. It's basically 4 stages broadly. You know, the egg, the larva, or a caterpillar. Then it becomes into cocoon, and then the butterfly. So 2 stages of yours is already over. The egg and the caterpillar. The egg when you are born, the caterpillar when the mother takes care of you, when you're growing up, the parents teaches you how to walk, they feed you to be strong. So that stage is also over. And now when the caterpillar stage is over, what does the caterpillar do? It gets into a cocoon so that it is invisible from the outer world. You all are aware this happens so that it is not killed by the other predators. So similarly, now you're at the 3rd stage of your life, which is a cocoon. And what does the caterpillar do in that cocoon? It introspects itself, meditates, learn things about life, which you are doing it over here. The caterpillar is focused, and when it breaks the cocoon and comes out, it turns out to be a beautiful butterfly. This is what we expect all of you to be in future. Beautiful butterflies, doing the best wherever you go, whatever you do, and everybody who sees you feels happy. We all feel very happy when we see a butterfly. I recollect when I was a kid, I used to catch butterflies. Those days are over. We all have done it, but not anymore. So be focused. You must dream. What do you want? And here, when you are in cocoon now, ponder over it. and give your best. Tomorrow you shouldn't be saying, had I put in a little more effort, I could have done that. This sentence or a thought process should never come to your mind. You have to give in your best and be the best. Because outside world, it's a cutout competition. And the facilities which the school has provided you, they cannot beat you, I'm very, very sure. Coming on to the school council members which have been elected, all these positions comes with additional responsibilities. So you must remember what kind of responsibilities are being entrusted upon you. And give your best. You have already taken the pledge. Go into the deep meaning of this pledge. It is not mere taking the pledge. Go into the meaning of this pledge. Follow it. And I tell you, if you follow it throughout your life, you will be a happy person. And the country will be proud of you. At the end, I would only say, chase your dreams. You must dream, chase your dream, put in all the efforts and achieve it. And God will be with you. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your enlightening speech. Your words are a source of motivation.